Now that my index page is ready, it's time to convert the article page. This is a page with a lot of content, so let's start with the page settings. Because this page will be used for standard posts and standard pages, according to the WordPress template guidelines, I define that it will be exported as singular PHP in my theme. Before starting to add WordPress actions and to simplify the process, I give a name to the different sections of the Webflow template. Now, I can add my main loop by using the Show Posts action. I set the main content section as the end of the range of the loop. I add the post featured image action to the header section. And I set the image thumbnail size to large, which is a default WordPress value. Next is the All Stories button, which I link to the home with the site link smart action. For the photo credits, I use a very smart tweak. I start by adding a custom query with the Show Post smart action. And I set the post to load option value to featured image, which is a very useful predefined value. Then, I add the post excerpt smart action to the element. This particular flow will display the media caption if it's available. Now, from the main content section, I add the post title smart action to the H1 title. I set the subtitle part to Don't Export because I don't want it. And I use the post content smart action to the next paragraph. For all the other elements, I set to Don't Export action. Now I have my first part ready. I save, then export. And from my local WordPress, I can now display my posts. I see the featured image in the header. I can use the All Stories link. And I see the full content of my posts. Back to Pinegrow Theme Converter, I add a few names to some elements. And I'm ready to deal with the next step, which is about adding the suggested stories content.